Hello, my name is John Ball. I'm the South Dakota Department of Ag's Forest Health Specialist and South Dakota State University's Extension Forestry Specialist, and this is for today's forest. What we need to talk about are thinning trees, and as you can see in the stand behind me, these trees definitely need to be thinned. Well, here we are in another part of the same property, and obviously this has been thinned. And if you remember, we want to go back to Skip Smith's little segment on thinning when we talked about silviculture, is that we thin the forest to help increase the vigor of the remaining trees. We've opened up the stands, and if you also want to go back and take a look at our mountain pine beetle segments, we've also talked about by opening up the stands, we reduce the risk to mountain pine beetle because we're providing conditions in which the beetle does not fly as well. But it opening up the stand also reduces fire risk. And so thinning is a very important aspect of forest management. Well, once you've thinned out the trees, the smaller diameter trees and the tops, we refer to as slash. And that's material that's often left on site. Now that can be lopped and scattered, spread across the site, but no higher than about 18 inches. And by doing that, as that slowly rots away, it returns the elements to the soil. Another common means is to pile it such as this. What this allows is that the Ips beetle, pine engraver beetle, a cousin to the mountain pine beetle, which we discussed in other segments, will invade the slash here and will begin to chew its way through this. And as long as this stays green, they'll stay in the pile. And then what you do is in the wintertime, you burn the pile. And so you're killing the Ips. The problem is, if the pile dries out during the summer and the Ips are no longer finding any food in here, they can move and start attacking the adjacent trees, very similar to what occurs with mountain pine beetle.
If you are going to burn your own slash pile, state law requires that you get a burn permit. The conditions for that are 2 to 3 inches of lasting snow cover. The cool temperatures throughout the week are generally going to help that snow cover last. We also do request that you monitor your piles until they are out and cold.
In some situations, all the slash is removed. Removing all the slash, not allowing any to remain on the site after the harvesting, is something a lot of fire people prefer.
Well, the reason we like to see all the slash removed is it results in a lower fire intensity. If we still have the slash left on the ground, it doesn't really remove our fire problem, it just changes the location of it. We have the tree going from standing up to laying on the ground. And then in a fire event, it's just the same intense fire, it's just a little bit lower to the ground. It is more manageable, we can respond to it, but it's not the ideal conditions that we'd like to see.